今日はここ渋谷にあるセーフキャストのワークショップに来ています。でセーフキャストは何かっていうと、全国で放射能のレベルを民間レベルで測定をして、そのデータをインターネットで共有するっていうシステムを作ったグローバルネットワークなんだけれども、彼らのすごいところっていうのが、本当に誰でも作れるガイガーカウンター制作キットっていうのを開発したんですよ。で今日はここの渋谷のオフィスでガイガーカウンターを作るワークショップがあるってことだったので、今日はここに来てみました。でこれから私も自分でガイガーカウンターを作ってみたいと思います。
あ、よろしくお願いします。ゆかです。よろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いいたします。
I mean, SafeCast started after the 3/11 earthquake in Japan because there was no radiation data available for people. So we created a platform, both hardware and software, for people to go out and collect data and then publish that to the web. In the very early hours after the 3/11 earthquake, I reached out to some friends of mine who were in Japan, and over a very short period of time, a handful of hours, we had a small email chain where we were all sort of trying to figure out what was going on, trying to get information for our friends who were in Japan, and just not having any luck tracking down data. We were sort of horrified to find that it wasn't that we just weren't any good at finding the data, it's that the data just didn't exist. And so being sort of a collection of technologists and hackers and web people, we thought that we could just kind of dive into this project and provide some valuable resources to it.
No.
So when we initially started SafeCast, we only had a handful of devices, and we realized very quickly that we couldn't take a large number of readings, you know, with just a bunch of handheld devices that we were kind of walking around with, taking a spot reading here and a spot reading there. And that's when we came up with the concept to turn them into mobile sensors. Over the last 2 years, we've refined that device. In these revisions of our hardware platform, we've been trying to think and keep in mind how we could get it to the point where other people could build these devices as well, not just us. It's largely off-the-shelf pieces, so someone could just like download a parts list and go to a hardware store, electronics store, and buy the parts for it.
It isn't all of them. It doesn't really matter. So it's basically in the middle.
いいね。超楽しいね、これ。
Trim them all close.
Because SafeCast is a very sort of lean, kind of scrappy punk rock organization to some extent, we were able to move really fast and just get things done. We've published over 12 million data points, and that's sort of in contrast to Japanese government, which has published around 30,000 or so. Like a government or even a major corporation could never move at the speed that something like SafeCast moves at, because we didn't ask anybody's permission. You know, we don't have paperwork to file. We just did it.
もともとなんでセーフキャストのことを知ったんですか？
彼に。
あ、ここが全部つながってくるんです
。お友達です。あの震災以降ずっといわきとか福島に行ってるので、まあ、線量計1個持ってるんですけど、こっちの方が分かりやすいのと、アプリも教えてもらっていい
ですか？あー、ね。
僕、あいつは神戸出身なんです
よ。あ、そうなんですか。
それで弟とか知り合いとかも出てて、でこのセーフキャストっていうグループがあるっていうのを知って、それで1台借りてて、で今日も持ってきてるんですけど、でも自分でも1台欲しいなと思ってたから。
If you wanted to know what the weather was like, you know, in Tokyo right now, and I told you that on average in Japan it's 25, it doesn't really help you to know whether you need a jacket outside of your house. And that's kind of how radiation was published, in these huge averages. So it wasn't that it was necessarily incorrect, it wasn't very useful. We were getting readings all the way down to a specific GPS point, down to a street address. And once we started publishing that data, and once people realized that the data could be much more precise, then they were no longer willing to accept, you know, a giant one average reading for all of Tokyo.
Okay. Come on. Bam.Oh, yeah! Geiger counter 作っちゃいました。How does this thing work? Like, how does it measure the radiation?
Well, let me tell you a couple things about it. One, there's a big sensor tube here. And this sensor is filled with a gas that when any radioactive particle gets inside, it ionizes that gas and causes a pulse, which is detected by this board and then counted by the little computer here.
Okay, little computer there.
There's a small computer here.
Okay.
Okay, so We have two basic ways to use it.
Yeah.
With this mode switch up, this is like contamination mode.
Okay.
And you'd use this for finding hot spots in your garden or places you want to clean up.
Right.
So in this way, we expect you to use it outside the case just like this.
Yeah.
And put it near things and see what's radioactive.
Okay.
So the blue light here,
yeah,
it blinks every time there's a radiation event.
Okay.
Okay, so there's not much radiation here.
Yeah.
But I have a piece of wood.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. There was a family that was in Koryama that they built a new deck, and they built it just before the reactor accident.
Yeah.
So on the day that the fallout came down, the wood was fresh and new.
Mm-hmm.
Because they didn't know any better, the next weekend they had another party and they varnished the deck.
Mm-hmm.
So they covered the contamination with varnish. So
okay.
What that did was that sealed the radioactive contamination onto the top of the wood.
Right.
And that's good for us because it makes it safe. We can touch it. The radiation can't come off because it's under the layer of varnish.
Right.
But you'll find out, if you look at this, if you get this close to here, it's very active. So the light blinks very wildly.
Whoa.
And there's a lot of activity from it. And it's only on one side. On this side, there's nothing.
Wow.
Okay, on this side, it's contaminated.
Oh, I can actually hear something too.
This is the speaker, yeah.
Right.
If we want to measure the hazard to people or the dose rate, then the proper way to use it is to put it in the case.
Okay.
Now it's waterproof and calibrated for gamma.
Waterproof.
You hang it on the outside of your car or on your backpack when you're bicycling or walking,
yeah,
and drive around or bicycle around,
yeah,
and it'll make a map of what the radiation levels are every 5 seconds wherever you go.
Wow.
とここに作った外貨カウンターが出来上がりました。で今日はこのバイスのオフィスでどれぐらいこの辺に放射能レベルがあるかっていうのを見てみたいと思います。今150マイクロシーベルトだね。でこれはまあ東京で言ったら結構普通の数字でも、実際のところ福島の原発事故が起こる前までは約これの半分ぐらいだったらしい。だからまあ2倍になってるっていうと結構大きく聞こえるけれども、まあ、0.15 マイクロシーベルトっていうのは、まあ、そんな高い数字ではない。うん。だね。まあ、ちょっとこれを使ってその辺を歩き回ってみたいと思います。
To get it to the point now where in a weekend we can build 20 devices that are walking away with volunteers who are going to go take readings and send them back to us is just massive. And you know, this is probably the fourth or fifth of these that we've done in Japan. So this has really multiplied the amount of data that we're able to collect and bring in and publish back out. So it's pretty fantastic.
あれだね、この辺に来るとどんどん下がるね。なんだろうね、バイスのオフィスちょっとちょっとだけ放射能高いかもね。
We've partnered with a huge amount of people around Japan to help collect data in their regions, which then they publish back to this. So, well, we don't necessarily have any interaction with federal government. We have a lot of interaction, very supportive interaction with local governments.
で、この一周してきた私の歩いた道のりっていうのが、パソコンにインターネットにアップしたときに地図上で見えるっていう仕組みになってるみたいです。うん。OK、じゃあアップロードしてみましょう。で今ここでサブミットが完了したので、あとはこのデータをセーフキャストの人が確認をして承認がされたら、こういうここみたいな iPhone のアプリとかでみんなが見える情報として公開されるっていう仕組みです。
People are not willing to just sort of take what's handed to them anymore. I think that people in JapanNow, you know, we'll ask questions that they might not have asked before, and we'll sort of dig a little deeper and not accept an answer that they aren't happy with. And I think that Safecast is a good example of how that works out, as well as a very clear representation of how someone can actually take matters into their own hands and provide something, you know, for the better of everyone else.